Next time you're talking with someone who doesn't think it's a problem that more and more of the nation's wealth and income are going to the top, mention these seven economic fundamentals. Number one, workers are consumers. Number two, consumer spending accounts for 70% of all economic activity in the United States. Number three, people at the top spend a much smaller portion of their incomes than people in the middle class and below. Number four, so when most of the economic gains go to the top, there's not enough purchasing power to keep the economy moving. Number five, which means that in order to have sufficient demand for goods and services, a larger share of total income has to go to the middle class and the poor. Number six, which requires a higher minimum wage, a bigger earned income tax credit, lower taxes on the middle class and the poor, financed by higher taxes on the wealthy, and stronger unions capable of negotiating higher wages. Seven, these don't hurt the wealthy. It's not a zero-sum game. In fact, the wealthy will do better with a smaller share of a rapidly growing economy than they're doing now with a large share of an economy that's barely growing at all. These are the seven economic fundamentals. Spread them.